Hello, welcome to St Anne's. My name is Elena and I'm studying for a DPhil in history here. I'm the women's officer in the MCR. St Anne's is a mixed college of undergraduate and graduate students. We have about 300 graduate students from over 60 countries. This is the college's dining hall. We have informal meals here, breakfast, lunch and dinner every single day, except on the weekends we just have brunch, but that's a pretty nice meal. It's pretty cheap, you get a lot of food. And you'll see that we have lots of light in this room, not much kind of wall space, so no portraits, which is quite unusual in an Oxford college. We have Christmas dinner here. We have a special Founders Day dinner, which is quite unique to St Anne's, where we celebrate the women founders of the college, and they come back, the ones that are still around, to kind of speak about their experiences at the college, and it's a really nice day. Okay, so this is the original college building, and it houses the old library, and we actually have two libraries. The reason we have that is because this was founded as the Society for Oxford Home Students, and it was founded so that women could come to Oxford more cheaply before they could actually gain degrees, but they could go and be in private lodgings and it would be a bit cheaper, and then they could come here during the day to study. And that's why our mascot is a beaver, because the idea is that they all go away and they kind of beaver away together during the day, and then they go home to their own little kind of haven at the end of the day. So part of the reason we have two libraries is because women were not allowed in the Oxford libraries for a very long time. So we benefit now because we have a lot of books, but that's the legacy. So this is the original library at St Anne's, and combined with the other one, we have 110,000 books. And you can make requests all the time, so I've done that a few times and got some specialist books that I can access, couldn't access elsewhere, so it's a really nice ever-growing library. And in the new one we have some seminar spaces as well that you can rent out, and you can book rooms for group study, and we have grad student shut up and write sort of co-working sessions in there. Okay, this is the new library building, and when you come here as a graduate student you are assigned a personal tutor who is normally in your subject, and they're the person that you can go to for any welfare concerns or any problems about your course that you wouldn't be able to speak to your supervisor about. And we have discussion groups every so often, and it will normally be a graduate student who talks about their research and gets to talk to the rest of the graduate community about that over lunch. Pretty nice. So this is Eleanor Pune House, it's the MCR, and it's actually like a little house, which is quite nice. Hello. And people live here. So I think we have about 15 bedrooms for graduate students upstairs. And then the big graduate accommodation site is in Summertown, which is slightly north of Oxford. And then we have the main MCR common room. And not many people here at the moment, but this is nice because this is kind of the noisy, busy room. And yeah, it's just a nice place to come in the evening. We have a lot of social events. I can show you a calendar in a moment. But we have something pretty much twice, three times a week. So we also have the MCR study room, which is quiet during the day, and then in the evening you can sort of book it out, and we have film nights and things like that. And you'll see that we have lots of comfy bin bags. Okay, so this is the kitchen where anyone can come and cook, and it's fully equipped. And our pride and joy of an espresso machine that everyone appreciates. And then this is the college coffee shop. So this is a place where people can come and study, and we have a really wide range of sandwiches, there's pizzas, there's lots of nice kind of treats as well. Oh, it might be locked. Yeah, okay. So through here is the college bar, not open at the moment, but we have a really nice pool table in there, and we often have live music events, so we have quite a few people in college who like to share their music, and that's always really fun, and a nice subsidised bar. So we have a full welfare support system here. We have a nurse who's on site, and we also have three junior deans and MCR peer supporters, so it's nice to have that kind of range of people that you can go to. I'm not actually sure exactly where I know that the nursery is around here. I think St Anne's was the first college to provide a nursery, but I'm not entirely certain. St Anne's does provide a little bit of extra financial support for graduate students, so we have a termly travel grant for your research, and they've also just introduced research grants to help you with things like thesis binding, printing costs. I got some help for some costs for a database that I need to access of historical newspapers, that kind of thing. I'm the MCR Women's Officer here, and it's a really exciting week this week because International Women's Day is coming up, and in conjunction with the JCR Women's Officer, we're organising an event to celebrate 100 years of female graduates, because women could graduate 100 years ago, and some of the first female graduates are from this college. So we organise those kind of events, and as graduate students we can often travel a lot, be away for a few weeks or months at a time, but when someone does go away and come back and kind of sit down at the dining hall for lunch, it feels like they've never been away. It's like they're coming home, and we have a real sense of community, so that's what I really like the most.